Hey, this is Scott Joffrey Banzai. Today we're taking a look at Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2020. I recently bought this version of it because it has CR3 RAW support. So with the Canon EOS M50 that I have, now I can finally go into their software and not have to convert to DNG RAWs to edit with Acdsee. Super nice, that is the main reason I picked it up. We're going to go over the software itself. I've modified some things in the settings. It might look a little different if you download the demo. Here is the Manage tab. You have a folder list on the side, one in the center, all of your options on the top, and the main tabs on the top right. I have those a little smaller than usual, but you get the idea. So in the Manage, this is basically a lot of the ways to move files around, change some settings, copy paste, and all of that. Let's go into this folder here. We just look at a few different photos. So we go into CR3, see it is reading those files. That's a big deal for me. You can easily select things. See on the side here, all of the EXIF information that it pulls. And of course, the DNGs work just fine as well. What I was doing previously is using the DNG converter, which I'll pull up real quick. If you have an older version of this or some other software, usually you can convert to DNGs. And they're more compatible in general. Acdsee is database focused. It's good and bad in some ways. I just try to ignore it. It's just one way of storing information about photos that it reads from the disk and all that, or any edits and changes that you make. That's just fine. I just let it do its thing. But you can push the XMP sidecar files for RAWs, and you can push information into DNGs, files like that. There is a setting which I want to show you first. So you go into the options, tools options, and database here. It says display embedded Acdsee metadata reminder. I have this on shutdown, so when I close the application, if it needs to make those sidecar files, it'll do that. It'll give you the option to do that. In the top right here, we have a photo tab. Let's look at that real quick. Now, I don't have a lot loaded into this database for the new version. I didn't try to convert anything. I just want to start fresh. As you can see, it pulls up a lot of information. You can look at a ton of photos. It does dates and everything, so that's just the few files that I've loaded into here. That's one way of looking at your pictures. Pretty nice. I don't really use it too much, but it is an option. Go back to Manage, select one of the photos, and go into View. I use this quite a bit. It's very quick to look at the pictures. You can zoom in, you can scroll very easily, you can switch down here with the keys and the keyboard. It's a really nice way to view files. Gives you some information on the side. You can do the embedded preview or the raw that it generates a preview for that directly, which is nice. So if I want to get into actually editing this file, I go into develop. This is the main tab that I use a lot besides the manage and the view. In develop, you can zoom in, whatever you want, scroll around. Works pretty nicely. They've improved the speed of this through the different generations of software that I've used. Started with 2017, but here you can do the standard adjustments, contrast, just a lot of options, white balance, light EQ. I use these quite a bit. You can push some of the shadows, highlights. It works really well. You change the different types. So definitely a good amount of options. You've got color adjustments, saturation. You can go in the picture itself and adjust with the mouse. Photo effects, if you want like the Instagram look to pictures, that's in there. Grain, color LUTs, which I haven't used yet. This is a newer feature. That's just the main tab there. Detail gives you sharpening, noise reduction, things of that nature. Skin tune is another thing to adjust for the people's faces. And chromatic aberration adjustments. With the geometry, it's nice that with the new CR3 support, I'm seeing that the M50 is in there, the profiles. They have quite a few more, at least, than previous. So we've got the original EOS M, M50, M5, M3, 2, M100, M6. I'm not seeing the M200, but it's better than nothing. So here you can crop and do things of that nature. Everything in the Develop tab is non-destructional, so that way you can do things like this tab, which is Repair. You can actually right click here, it's basically a healing tool. You got the clone and works like you would expect. So if I try to erase things, you get the idea. That's not the fastest thing ever, but it does work. So you can actually copy and paste settings. So if I wanted to save all these settings and push them into another picture, I can do that with selections of what I want to copy and paste. And then just right click on another one, paste it in there, and it will push those changes. So everything from the repair tool to any of these sliders will be pushed. The edit tab is like Photoshop. You have different layers. You can basically do a lot of the similar things. You do a lot of the adjustments in the develop tab as well, but these are raster based, so you're gonna have to save a new file for these edits. But you do actually have more settings here, like liquify, things you won't be able to do in the develop tab. It does have some special features like frequency separation, which I haven't really gotten into, even though I've had it for previous versions. But things like that you want to use with portraits of people. As you can see here, it wants you to save a new file because it is raster based, basically like a Photoshop file, but with Acdsee. They have an add-on that comes with the application that you can right-click on files in the Folder Explorer, and you get a preview of it. As you can see, it's got Canon EOS M50, the CR3, which is great, and you can click on that. It pops up in another application for previewing. So a nice quick way of doing that. Going to develop with a person photo, we can do quite a few adjustments that I didn't mention with the other type of photos. So I said the soft focus, can add a glow to it. I think that's actually a new one. I don't remember that being in the previous version. We also have this one here, the skin tone. Let's go in a little closer. You can adjust that to basically remove some of the blemishes from people. The differences. So nice little feature there, quick way to simply adjust the skin a little bit, which I do use. Some of the things that I also do with this program is rename files to use it in my videos. So if you've seen some of my videos where I have on the top, it's got the EXIF information, I rename the file themselves. That way I have some of that information embedded in there. When I pull it into my video editor, I can just copy paste that information. It's a quick way to do that stuff. So go into renaming. This drop down, you just have to add some information that you want. So insert metadata, could add different things like aperture, ISO, and then it'll change. It'll give you a way of seeing what it might look like. Really nice way to adjust naming and such. Of course, you have the different information like adding colors to different pictures or ratings. You can right click and rating. It's a nice way to pick files, cull files, which I do a lot with the photography. So far so good. It feels a little quicker than the previous version, which is very nice. Any tiny little improvement in processing speeds helps out a lot because you're doing maybe a ton of photos. It really helps. There is so much to it. It does face detection. It does a whole bunch of things that I haven't even tried out. And it did it in some of the previous versions as well, but in this one, maybe I'll eventually get a chance to check it out. That was a look at Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2020. Hope you enjoyed the video. Just a quick look, going over some of the things that I use and talking about CR3 RAW support, which is a big deal for me. I'm gonna say it 10 million times. Scott Photography Banzai. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks.